guys, how are you? Welcome back. It's been about a week since my last video about dating with a purpose, and I hope you enjoyed it or got something out of it. I'm going to be talking about my past and what's kind of made me who I am today as far as my self-esteem and all of that stuff. Kind of like fester. I don't like that word. Do you like that word, fester? I try to really think about, let's not show too much here. I try to really simmer on it. Maybe that's a better word than fester on it. About what's on my mind and something I want to share about. And then I don't do like an outline or anything. I just try to think about some key topics I want to talk about that kind of tie into the week before, so it's not completely random. And since I'm on a little bit of a dating slash relationship tangent for the next couple weeks, this kind of ties into it and why I am the way I am. And maybe some of you guys can relate, maybe some of you guys can't. I also found out that at least one guy watches my videos, so thank you. That was the worst wink I've ever done. I talked about this, I'd have to go through all my videos, sometimes I forget. I was a very late bloomer, and I want to tell you this, not because I want to live in the past or because I want to be woe is me. I don't want to be act like a victim. Let me start by saying that I am very happy. I don't know if happy is the right word. I'm very grateful for the past that I have, because I really think that it's set me up to be the person I am. It's made me more humble, and it's made me more appreciative of where I am now, because I was such a late bloomer. So in high school, so let's start from the beginning. So like in grade school, I was like okay, and then around like fifth grade, I started to get taller slash bigger than everybody else. And I think the way you are in your dynamics with men when you're younger, I'm talking specifically to women because I can't really like say from a guy's point of view, your dynamics with men, with kids, boys, teachers, any male figures when you're a child really like kind of sets the tone for how you're going to date when you get older. And it might sound silly, but like it really does. That's why the daddy issue is, because your dad kind of sets the tone for the guys that you want to go for when you're older. That's a whole other video. I don't have time to get into daddy issues. But I will say around fifth grade is when I started going through my awkward years, and I was bigger, I was taller. And I had this one teacher in fifth grade who used to call me Thunder Thighs. That's, you know, I was thinking about this last night. I'm like, how was that okay? Like if I found out that anyone was doing that to my daughter now, I would lose it. But yeah, he used to call me Thunder Thighs, and he used to say I was gonna break the cracks in the floor, and I'm kind of like laugh it off. He was like kind of a funny teacher. But it wasn't funny, and I remember just like not saying anything and kind of laughing it off. But when I look back, I'm like, wow, that was really kind of traumatizing then, to be called Thunder Thighs by your fifth grade teacher and have everybody laugh. And then, you know, I was always like kind of the girl that got picked last for sports. I'm not one to ever say I was sporty, which is okay. And then, you know, sixth, seventh, eighth grade, probably like progressed a little bit, and around eighth grade, people used to moo at me. So I was never like, in my opinion, like severely obese or anything. I was just like a big girl. I was bigger than a lot of the people I went to in school, which it was a very small school. Like 99 was our graduating class, like amount of people. And I graduated 99 with 99 people. And I had like two or three friends, I remember. And I just remember, you know, like you start to think like, do I remember these things clearly? And of course you do. And a lot of the bullies, they don't remember bullying you. They're like, oh, I thought it was nice to you. I'm like, you weren't. But the thing is like when you are being bullied, you never forget. When you are the bully, you tend to forget. Just remember that. If you're younger watching this, because I know some of my daughter's friends watch this, just remember, if you're unkind to people, if you're bullying, if you're saying hurtful things about someone's appearance or whatever, that will stick with them sometimes for life. And some people aren't strong enough to handle that, and it really defines their self-worth and their self-esteem. So I tell my daughter all the time, like, you don't have to be friends with everybody, but don't participate in bullying. Don't even be around it, you know. In fact, stand up for them, be an advocate for the person. And even if you feel like it's justified, like maybe they're not a nice person, and I want you guys to really think about, for the young people that watch this, about being compassionate, because you don't really know what their situation is. So really just think about your words and what you say to people, because that can really define a lot of the rest of their life. I know that's a lot of pressure to put on you, but it absolutely is true. I mean, I'll never forget, you know, being out somewhere and being mooed at like a cow. You know, if I remember being in a history class and we were watching this video with cows in it, and I just wanted to sink into my desk because all these boys, you know, were doing the low, and the teachers never said anything. And it's like, okay, yeah, this is not a sob story, people. This is like a Cinderella story, except for I didn't find a prince yet. But I'm telling this story not because I want anyone to feel sorry for me. I'm telling this story because it's really made me a who I am today, and I'm grateful for the experiences. And I think that when I was in high school, I always knew deep down in my heart that I would be a different person. I would be the person that I am now. I would be stronger, I would be confident, I would be compassionate to others. Do I participate in like making fun of people sometimes? Yeah, I do. It's wrong, and I don't want to admit it, but sometimes I have to catch myself and be like, Sarah, you're not that girl, don't make fun of people. And I just remember how hurtful it felt in that time. So even though, you know, around senior year, I lost weight, and both times I got pregnant, I'd gained a significant amount of weight, but I lost it. I'm pretty like confident in my body now. It's not perfect, but you know, we're all a work in progress, and I work on it and whatever, that's besides the point. But I, even after I lost weight and became who I am today, sometimes it's hard for me not to see like that fat girl in high school or middle school or grade school who was picked on. And sometimes I forget that, you know, people really do just kind of like use you for how you look instead of who you are as a person. And sometimes it's not about like, oh my gosh, I'm not pretty. Like, tell me I'm pretty. No, seriously, I'm not. It's about how you see yourself through the lens of other people. So if you're putting all your self-worth into how people see you physically, you're always going to compare yourself to somebody else, because you know the Kardashians of the world or the people on Instagram of the world, you're never going to feel like you look like that, or you're never going to feel like, and beauty can be bought, let's be honest here. So if you are putting all of your value into your actual looks, you're always going to fall short. Not to mention the fact that, listen, I'm going to be 38 in April. Like, I'm not young. I mean, I'm young, but I'm not like growing down, I'm growing up, I'm getting older, and you can't put all your value into how you look. If it hadn't been for those people tearing me down when I was younger, if it hadn't been for the people making fun of me, if it hadn't been for the people not noticing me, you know, no boys asked me out in high school. I didn't have a boyfriend until I was like 15, and he lived in Delaware. That's another story. But I didn't really like experience anything until I moved to New York City when I was 19. And then I was like, oh wow, like I'm not ugly, people like me. But if I hadn't experienced all of that, kind of criticism and hurtfulness from other people, it wouldn't have made me compassionate. It wouldn't have made me kind of empathize with other people who have been in a situation. You know, like the worst, I'm sorry, this sounds judgy, but like I could never really have, take real compassionate advice from a personal trainer that's never had a weight issue. Or I'm not saying that they're not, and I don't know how that comes off, but it would be hard for me personally, because it's really easy to sit there and put yourself in someone else's shoes, but unless you've been in, it's like me telling a drug addict I know exactly how they feel because I've done heroin before. I've never done heroin before. I can be compassionate, I can be understanding, but unless you've been the fat girl that's been mooed at, or the fat guy or whatever, you just, it's hard to be compassionate, but you don't need to be that person to be someone who understands. So I guess my message for today is just more of like, it's not so much like an inspirational message, it's more just like some background on who I am and why I am the way I am. People make fun of me for posting a lot of selfies on Instagram. You know, listen, I like who I am. I like what I've accomplished. I like how I look. I mean, do I get down on myself? Absolutely. Do I put all of my value into how I look? No, I can't. And when I go out with a guy, I always say, listen, I don't say this, but I think in my mind, like, there's a bunch of other hot girls out there. There's younger girls. There's girls with bigger boobs, bigger butts, bigger whatever, whatever. But there's only one of me. There's only one person who has my personality. There's only one person who has my heart. There's only one person who is unique like me. And I don't mean that that makes me more special than them. It just means that you have to really think about what you bring to the table personally. Don't just put all your value on how you look or what you're wearing. Or, you know, there's a lot of people with really kind hearts that are very average looking that could get the guy that you could never get. You know why? Because that guy sees something in that girl that is not just about looks. And every guy, behind every hot girl, there's a guy that's bored of her. You know, you've heard that. And behind every hot guy that has no substance, there's a girl that's bored of him too. You cannot put all your value into how you look. So whatever your background is, whether you were bullied, whether you were the bullier, whether you were the popular girl, because they get crap too for being always popular. I mean, a lot of girls that were always popular, they get shit on because people are like, you don't know what it's like. Well, guess what? They probably had their own struggles too. So let's just, like I always say, let's just be a little easy with each other. Let's try to understand where we're coming from. Let's be compassionate. Let's definitely not bully. And let's really think about what we are, what we have to offer a person apart from our hair, our hoops, and our outfits and our body. Let's really just like think about what who we are and what we have to offer another person, you know, inside of our heart and our brain and our passions and our life. And that is all. Next week, I'm going to be talking about the red flags of dating. I could write a book on that. So stay tuned for that. I hope you're having a great week. Thank you guys again for the comments. All of it means the world to me. Sometimes I think people aren't watching and then they comment and I'm just inspired and encouraged once again. I will see you soon. Have a great rest of your day.